Good evening, everyone. My name is John Robinson, I live at 3227 Sandaline Circle, Lake Park. And I'm here tonight to speak to you about issues pertaining to our community. I've met with Chairman, Mr. Pope, Pritchard, and with every different time and location, speaking about issues pertaining to our community. We do have problems here, and we're trying to solve them. And what I'm basically going to be talking about here tonight is that I filed a complaint against the city and the county based upon Section 3 of the Martin Luther King corridor, which I know that the city, but the county might not have that much to do with it. When we got engaged in conversation with the city, they let us know that there were some issues pertaining to this corridor that came into play when we were talking about the expansion on the issues. And those issues were that when we got to talking about that Title 3, Section 3 of the HUD program states that the minority workers and the people from the community should be working in those areas, which we didn't see this take place. And therefore it raised some issues. And it invoked Title 6 of the United States Constitution with amendments. And it states that no person in the United States on the ground of race, color, natural origin shall be excluded from participating in, denied the benefits of, nor be subjected to discrimination on any by any program or activity receiving federal financial assistance, especially the impact that it brings on disparities. Where the county came into this complaint, now this is only a complaint, because we're trying to find some answers, because we can't seem to get answers from other portions. We're working with everyone very closely with the VSAL program that the city put in place, trying to help bring about economic change in our community, because we're trying to get some money on the south side. It seems that as if the entire community have been neglected, and seems as if the MPO, the Metropolitan Planning, did not include this community or these people that is required, because we got Moody Air Base here, and it spends $450 million here, and we have other entities here that brings everybody into the picture, because if one dime of federal funds is spent on this side, it interferes with the money that's spent on the other side. And we feel that the community have been totally neglected as well and excluded. Upon those grounds there, I did file a federal complaint, and I want you guys to be aware to file a complaint. And by me filing a complaint, I know it might sound a little bit awkward, I'm still asking for you to help us in this to see if we come to some kind of resolve or resolution. The problem that I see that we're having so far is that we can't seem to get any answers. When we go, I'm working with the Governor Neal, I'm going to wind this up. I'm working with Governor Neal out of Atlanta there, and he put me with the gentleman by the name of Mr. Brian Williamson, and he's over the Community Development Economics System, I believe it says. And he's got confused on the issues because it's so intermingled with laws. So therefore, we do have some laws as to notifications of bids and projects going out where it seems as if things are being hid and put as if it's being scrutinized for a special groups of people, people of power, instead of the people that's needing the money. We're looking at the disparity impact based upon the transit that's coming from the Moody Airways. Anyway, thank you for your time. I just wanted you to know that I did file a complaint, and I am expecting to get some help from you guys, even though I filed a complaint. Thank you.
As a point of clarification, Martin Luther King is totally a city project, and also Lowndes County has no Title III, Section 6 money.